Hey everyone, my name is Joe, and this is Something with Joe. In the previous video, we discussed the mole, and how to calculate the number of moles of a substance using mass, and the mass of a sample of a substance using moles. I'm currently in the middle of making another video, which I'll be uploading soon, which will feature more mass and mole calculations, but involving the use of conversion factors. So if you require the use of conversion factors for molar mass calculations, then please keep an eye out for that video. However, in today's video, we'll be going over another mole calculation, but without the use of conversion factors. But it's slightly trickier than the ones in the previous video, because it involves another step in the calculation. The calculation will involve working out the number of moles of a particular ion present in a sample of an ionic compound. Let's have a look at the question. How many moles of lithium ions are there in 47.0 grams of lithium sulfate? Now, the first thing to note is that we are being asked to work out the number of moles of lithium ions rather than just working out the number of moles of lithium sulfate in the sample. However, in order to work out the number of moles of lithium ions present in the sample, we first need to work out the number of moles of lithium sulfate present. Okay, so the first thing we have to do is consider the formula we're going to use for this calculation. And the formula we are going to use is this one, which states that in order to work out the amount in moles, we must divide the mass of the sample of the substance, which is given in grams, by the molar mass of the substance, which is the mass of 1 mole of the substance. Now, in order to work out the molar mass of the substance, we must consider the relative atomic masses of the elements present in the substance, despite the fact that this time we are dealing with a compound that consists of ions rather than atoms. Okay, so the next thing we do is we work out the molar mass of lithium sulfate, and to do that we must look at the chemical formula for lithium sulfate. So, according to the chemical formula for lithium sulfate, there are 2 lithiums, 1 sulfur, and 4 oxygens in every formula unit of lithium sulfate. So, to work out the molar mass of lithium sulfate, we must do the following. We're going to write M, because that is the symbol for molar mass, the equal sign, and then we're going to do this. 2 times the relative atomic mass of lithium, which is 6.94, put in brackets, plus the relative atomic mass of 1 sulfur, which is 32.1, and then we add on to that 4 times the relative atomic mass of oxygen, which is 16.0, which accounts for the 4 oxygens in lithium sulfate. So we then get an answer, a molar mass for lithium sulfate, which is 109.98 grams per mole. Okay, so as you can see, I have given the exact value of the molar mass of lithium sulfate. Now, the reason why I haven't rounded to a certain number of significant figures is because in this sort of calculation, you want to avoid rounding values earlier in the calculation to too few significant figures, because it could lead to inaccuracies later on in the calculation when you come to working out the final answer you want for the question. So, I have given the exact value of the molar mass of lithium sulfate, which is 109.98 grams, instead of rounding it to say 110. Okay, so now we know the molar mass of lithium sulfate, we can work out the number of moles of lithium sulfate in this sample. So, as we saw in our formula earlier on, to work out the number of moles, we need to know the mass, which is 47.0 grams, that's the mass of the sample, and we divide that then by the molar mass, which is 109.98 grams per mole, and then we give our answer to 4 significant figures, because once again we want to avoid a situation where we round answers to too few significant figures earlier on in the calculation to avoid inaccuracies later on. So we give our answer to 4 significant figures, which is 0.4274 moles. And to indicate that that is moles of lithium sulfate, we'll put the chemical formula lithium sulfate there. Okay, so now we have worked out the number of moles of lithium sulfate in the sample. But how do we work out the number of moles of lithium ions? Well, once again, we have to look at the chemical formula of lithium sulfate. Because as well as indicating the number of lithium, sulfurs and oxygens that are present in each individual formula unit of lithium sulfate, the chemical formula also indicates the number of moles of lithium ions and the number of moles of sulfate ions that are present in 1 mole of lithium sulfate. So according to the chemical formula, in 1 mole of lithium sulfate there are 2 moles of lithium ions and 1 mole of sulfate ions. And it is this information that we need to work out the number of moles of lithium ions in the sample. So, to work out the number of lithium ions in the sample, we need to do the following. We take the value of the number of moles of lithium sulfate present in the sample, which is 0.4274 moles of Li2SO4. So, 0.4274 moles of lithium sulfate. And we now multiply that by the number of moles of lithium ions there are in 1 mole of lithium sulfate, which is 2 moles. So we multiply it by 2.00 moles, and then we put Li plus to signify that it is 2 moles of lithium ions. So now we have all the information we need to work out the number of moles of lithium ions there are in 47.0 grams of lithium sulfate. So 0.4274 moles of lithium sulfate times 2 moles of lithium ions, and we get an answer to which we can now round to 3 significant figures, because it's our final answer to this question and we want to give our answer to the same number of significant figures that there are in the value in the question with a few significant figures. So in this case it's 3 significant figures, so our answer to 3 significant figures is 0.855 moles of lithium ions. So there we go, we have worked out that in 47.0 grams of lithium sulfate there are 0.855 moles of lithium ions, which makes sense because if you look at the value or number of moles of lithium sulfate in the sample, the number of moles of lithium ions are approximately twice the number of moles of lithium sulfate, which makes sense considering that in 1 mole of lithium sulfate you need 2 moles of lithium ions. So you need roughly twice as many moles of lithium ions for the number of moles of lithium sulfate you have in the sample. Okay, so there we go. We have now worked out the number of moles of a particular ion in a sample of a substance using this method. I hope you enjoyed this video and found it helpful. If you liked it, please give it a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Thank you for watching and I'll see you next time.